Hello people of BookTube, welcome to another video, and the hair has dyed, which means it's time for a wrap up. So in the month of August I managed to complete 6 books in total, which, you know, it's great. I'm not going to really mention that a couple of them were graphic novels, but it's still 6 physical books completed. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first book that I actually managed to complete in August was The Owl and the Fairy, volume number 4. Yay! I completed this volume. Now, I actually really, really enjoyed this one. I ended up giving this one a 5 out of 5 Kit Kats. And I just think the story in general is just really interesting. It's really fun. It's really cute. It's really quirky. And I definitely recommend it. The next book that I completed in August was Holding Up the Universe by Jennifer Niven. Now, my actual non-spoiler book review is up on this now. This book actually isn't released yet, but my review is up. So feel free to click around here. In fact, maybe click the book. I might put it on the book. So that will link you straight to the review. However, I will leave the review link in the description box below for those of you that don't have annotations working. But that's just more in detail what I thought about this. But all in all, what I can say about this book is I gave it 4.5 Kit Kats. And I just thought it was like really, really good. For me, it doesn't quite compare to All the Bright Places by Jennifer Niven because it's an all-time favourite, so this was hard to compare to it, but it still was really, really good. I really, really enjoyed it, and I definitely recommend it. The next book that I completed in August is another graphic novel, and this is called Madoka Magica, and it's volume number 1, so it's quite short. And I found this to be really quick read, really cute, really quirky. A great start to a series, and there was something in this, like an event that happened, which kind of like shocked me, and I'm just like, I need to know what happens next. So in the end, I gave this 4 out of 5 Kit Kats. The fourth book that I completed in August is Reasons to Stay Alive by Matt Haig. Now, I read this for the hashtag Eurothon because it was to read non-fiction books, so I'm glad that I managed to complete a book for it because I don't tend to do really well in readathons. But this book is really great for people who suffer with anxiety and depression, and I was actually going through a bit of anxiety when reading this book, so I found it does help. It's really great advice, and I did enjoy it, and I do recommend this. So I gave this 4.5 out of 5 Kit Kats. I then read a Geek Girl special story, which was Sunny Side Up. I will place the picture over here because I borrowed it from the library and I had to return it. But I obviously loved this to pieces because I just love every book that is in the Geek Girl series. I ended up giving this 5 out of 5 stars. It's just very funny, it's very hilarious, and even though it's like a side story, I still loved it and enjoyed it, and I recommend it. So I gave it 5 out of 5 Kit Kats. And the final book that I completed in August, it was a reread for me. Now, I haven't actually read this in years, so it's not actually been read on Goodreads until now, and I absolutely enjoyed it. Again, it's my third time reading it now, third time finishing it, and that is Starcrossed by Rachel Wing. And my god, this is so, so good. It's a very, very short novel. I love the cover to this. They did a cover change of it, and when I was reading it, I did tweet to the author that I was reading her book, and she was like, oh my god, the old cover. And you know, it was nice to know that I was reading her book, and you know, it was really great, so we had a little conversation about it. But yeah, I loved it again, of course. Like, it's just so cute, and it's just amazing. If you're a fan of Romeo and Juliet, I definitely recommend it. But this is just great. It's all about a girl and a boy, and their families have just had this fight. So it's very similar to Romeo and Juliet. So it's kind of like a Romeo and Juliet in real life thing. And then the boy and the girl are in the play of Romeo and Juliet. Obviously, they get cast as Romeo and Juliet, and it's just, they hate each other. They literally hate each other. So it's just like how they deal about all that. But it's told in second person, so it's like that you did this. So it's like you are the character, like the main girl character, which is pretty cool. But yeah, it's just, it's so good. It's just, it's short and it's quick, and it's just, Anyway, it's really satisfying at the end of it as well. So of course I gave this 5 out of 5 Kit Kats. It is one of my favourite reads because obviously reading it 3 times, you know, you can't tell it is a favourite of mine. But if you like your romances, if you like your cute contemporaries, then this is definitely for you, especially if you like the stories where the girl and the guy character like hate each other for the majority of the story, then this is definitely for you. So there you have it, guys. These are all the books that I completed in August, as well as Geek Girl Sunnyside Up. So please do let me know how you did in the month of August down in the comments below. Sorry that this is a late upload. I've been trying to find time to actually film and upload this video for you guys, because I've just been a busy bee, and whenever I get home from work, it's just the lighting is crap, let's be honest. So filming in the daytime at the weekend, and so it's done, it's dusted, it's out of the way, and I hope you have enjoyed my wrap-ups. If you have read in these books as well, please let me know your thoughts. It would be great to start a conversation about it, or if there's any books you would recommend to me just based on what I've read in August, then please let me know as well. I'm glad that I managed to get some reading done, because I didn't honestly think that I would with everything that was going on, but I'm super glad and I'm super proud. So for September, I'm going to hope to do the same. I always aim for like 5 books just because of how busy I get with work and all that. So 5 books is a decent amount, and I've already completed 1. So I've just got 4 books to go, and then I will be on my way. So good luck to me, good luck to you, and I'll see all of you in my next video. Bye.